Good evening, ladies. My name is Tasia Johnson. I stand before you this evening on the precipice of my 40th birthday, and I would like to start the evening out by telling you a little story. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful little princess who lived in a faraway land with her family. She loved life and enjoyed everything that was presented to her. And then one day, a very dark night came and brought sadness and hurt and pain. The little girl had nothing to do but allow that hurt and that pain to live inside of her, and eventually it grew into a beast. And then one day, a beautiful knight who looked like no other knight, he didn't have a shiny horse, he didn't have shiny armor, he didn't even have a visible sword, but he carried the sword of the Lord, and he saved that princess one night, and she lived on in the light for the rest of her life. That very brief story is a very condensed version of my life. Once I enjoyed life when I was young, and I loved my life. I thought I was invincible like Wonder Woman. And then one day, sadness came into my life, and I was sexually assaulted as a very young girl. I then was inappropriately touched by an adult trusted male in my life. So by the time I was 15 years old, I had pain inside of me that I had nowhere to go. So it grew and it grew and it turned into a beast. My family was religious, and so I figured that I could find happiness and kill the beast by being religious and spending time in trying to go to school. I was able to do that, and I got accepted to a really great school, pre-med, and then my hopes were dashed when I wasn't able to go to college. So again, that anger and that hurt grew and grew and grew. Eventually, I decided that I would further just dive into religion because that was something that was going to save me, and it would clean away all the dirtiness that I felt, the shame that I felt, the hurt that I felt. I got baptized in that religion, and I again thought that it was going to make me happy. About a year later, I realized I really wasn't happy. Nothing was changing. The beast was still growing. There was still pain. There was still hurt that was not going away. And this wasn't what I understood that God's love and God's light was supposed to be. So what little faith I had, I let that go, and I drifted, and that drift became living a very dangerous life. I was promiscuous, I drank, I did drugs, and by the grace of God, at 23 years old, I tried to commit suicide, and I didn't die. And so I figured, okay, I'm gonna start my life over. This is my opportunity for a fresh start. So I moved out of state, and I thought, great, I'm gonna start over, I'm gonna start in this new state, and everything's gonna be perfect, and it's gonna be beautiful. When I got there, I found out that I was pregnant. So again, all my hopes were dashed of a new life and a fresh start. So I came back to where I originally started. The religion that I was involved in decided that I needed to be involved in disciplinary action because of the lifestyle that I was leading. Those actions led me to lose my family, my friends, and everything that was normal to me at that time. Shortly after that disciplinary action went through, I lost my child in the second trimester of my pregnancy. At that point, I was so angry with God. I said, I hate you, God. You've taken my family. You've taken my child. I have no hope, and I'm filled with pain and hurt and sadness with nowhere to go. I walk away from you, God. I want nothing to do with you. And that's what I did. And I went back to my comforters. I went back to drugs. I went back to alcohol and continued to live a very reckless life. It then allowed me to be in a situation to, again, be sexually assaulted at about 27 years old. And because of my shame, because of my hurt, because of my fear, I moved here to Iowa and I got married and I said, let's start over again. I also chose to have an abortion that then continued to feed that beast and kill me on the inside. I was able to move here. I was involved in a very loving church at a point in time here in Iowa. Eventually, I was led to Saylorville. And one day, a beautiful knight came into my life and he shared with me the gospel that's found in the Bible, and he used the sword of the Lord, because at that point, God had brought me through so much pain and so much hurt that my heart was ready and was open to hear his plan of salvation. And there were things that I was told that I didn't have to have great works and do a bunch of things for God to love me and for God to save me, and that he had done that by sending his son to die for me. And in John 3:16, it tells us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. And at that point, I really believed that that was true. So one night, I gave my life over to God. And I said, if what you're telling me and what this night has brought to me in your word is true, then I give it to you. I surrender my life to you. If this is really what you want me to have, I will forever live my life doing what you have called and asked of me to do. That night, I gave my life over to God. It was the best thing that I've done. It allowed for me to be free. I don't have the shame. I don't have the pain. I don't have the hurt. God has redeemed me, and he has replaced that with his love, with his grace, and with his mercy. So if any of you today think that there's something that you have done that God can't fix, that God cannot heal, you're wrong. I believe that, and I was wrong. God can heal and redeem it all. All you have to do is just come and stand before him and surrender. Thank you.